It's only for a moment you were mine to hold. The plans that heaven has for you will all too soon unfold. So many different prayers I'll pray for all that you might do. But most of all, I wanna know you're walking in the truth. And if I never told you, I want you to know that as I watch you grow, I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you the courage to dare. Help you find your wings. May passion be the wind that leads you through your days, and may conviction keep you strong, guide you on your way. May there be many moments that make you
ready? One, Argon, one, two, three.
Oh, you're not surfing. You're walking the plank.
Surfing the plank.
Surfing the plank, you scurvy dog. Oi. There you go.
Thank you. Have adventures with him.
Mm-hmm.
Bring him back next summer. I promise I will bring him back next summer. I will share and I will not fight over him. And you also have to keep Andrew informed of how Puff is because he really...
Fight.
So make sure you keep Andrew informed on how Puff is doing. Okay.
Okay.
Cool. You can put your hand down. Yeah. Okay. So let's give it up for Stella and me.
We won't talk about that story. Okay, as you all well can see, this is total chaos. This is camp. And when we were practicing for this, we were trying to get it a little bit perfect, and then somebody said, you know what? Camp is never perfect. Why should this be perfect? So we're just going to have fun. We're hoping that all of you will enjoy this camp experience. Pretend that you're at Pentwater with the sun and the sand and our wonderful campfire that we all love at night, and we sing songs, and we'll be singing a bunch of them, and we're hoping that you will all join us. This is not a solo time. So, okay, the very first song we're going to do is This Is the Day, and we're going to divide everybody. What do I hear ringing? Right down from the cross, down. And most of you know this song. It's This Is the Day. We go, This Is the Day. This is the day that the Lord hath made, that the Lord hath made. So you're going to be the echo, and we're going to be the first. You'll catch on. So we need the music up there.
I can return to my seat up here I usually have after a Sunday like this. Some of these camp seats with rockers, I talked to the trustees about changing some of the seating in our sanctuary. It's a blessing to be here this morning, blessing to be the pastor of Otsego United Methodist Church, and with our camp musicians, our camp singers, our marshmallow gang, and with so many, along with our campership coordinators who really carry the mantle of camping ministries here at our church year-round, Sharon Carper and Beth Dorr, and with Kay Strong as our liturgist this morning. We welcome you and hope that you experience camp today as a place where Jesus' love is lived. Today, gathered around our campfire, we look to encounter our living God through the easy and more relaxed rhythms of camp, when we open doors, when we fellowship together, and when we leave room, Holy Spirit, to dwell among us and to blow through our campsites. And so, looking forward to our time in worship. Somehow, some way, we managed at this campground to have a bulletin this morning. So hopefully you've picked yours up on your way in, along with a communication card. If you're here today, ask that you drop those in the offering plate, just a way that we stay connected as a campground. If you're worshiping at home, we hope that you're well also. We hope that you've decided to dress more casually, perhaps, and in your camping best, and invite you to wave hello to us from your campground to ours in the comments section of whatever platform you're on this morning. You'll find your worship bulletin tucked into your email if you aren't yet receiving those weekly emails, and invite you to contact the church office. Be happy to add you. I want to highlight a few of the announcements that we have this morning. First is to put on your calendar Tuesday, April 23rd, if you're looking to grab lunch with a bunch of people. We have our lunch bunch coming together April 23rd at 11:30, gathering at the Crew Restaurant in Portage. There is a bulletin board sign-up sheet across from the library. I invite you to sign up for that today. Also want to highlight for you a upcoming community time of worship and of prayer. This is in conjunction with our nation's National Day of Prayer on May 2nd. And so the churches in our community are coming together for worship and for prayer. This will be on Saturday, May 4th from 5:30 to 7 at the Top Pavilion here in Otsego. Encourage you to bring a chair, and also look forward to a time in sharing worship with our community. There'll be music, there will be fellowship with other churches, and there must be a few Methodists in the crowd, because there's also going to be some food. So there you go. Finally, I do want to highlight for you our announcement regarding an update from the design team. You'll find that on page 4 of this morning's bulletin. Our design team is a steering committee that emerged from the small group last summer that is steering us in all of our decisions related to the upcoming general conference, which starts this coming Tuesday. We met this past Tuesday and to work on moving ahead on our path for discernment and decision. And so I want to update the congregation that at this meeting we worked on a number of handouts that we will be distributing to the congregation ahead of our likely church conference vote on whether to leave the United Methodist Church. Know that the goal of this path of discernment and decision is to resolve as much as possible all the matters that are before us at this time. And so we're working on that path, and the group met and worked on some handouts that will be distributed ahead of a likely church conference vote, including handouts on financial costs and implications of leaving the denomination. We also worked on a comparison guide, so so hopefully we can effectively communicate what are the distinctions between all the possible paths that rest ahead for our congregation, be it joining the Global Methodist Church, staying at United Methodist Church, or becoming an independent church. We also worked on a survey. It's a congregation-wide survey that we will conduct ahead of this likely church conference vote so we can begin to get a sense of how each of these might impact our congregation. In addition to this, individuals on the design team are working on putting together a final workshop for the congregation to help us understand for the Otsego Church to become an independent church. Also, our leadership and design teams are now considering a possible timeline for bringing all of this together for us. And so as soon as that timeline comes together, we will be sharing it with you as well. In the meantime, encourage us to continue in praying for the work of the General Conference, continuing to pray for our congregation, and trusting that God is bringing that path forward for our church. There's also still DVDs available at the Welcome Center. These are the two previous workshops. The Reverend Dwayne Bagley, who shares what it might look like to stay a United Methodist Church. And the other is Brother Don Wolfgang, who is the pastor at Pathfinder Church, which is a former United Methodist Church that has joined the Global Methodist Church. At that workshop, he shared information on what it would look like to become a Global Methodist Church, and so those are available. I just encourage us to continue this faithful work summer to discern our path forward. Finally, I want to bring us back to camp and just want to highlight in your bulletin today the information we have regarding the camperships that are available. It's wonderful to see so many children and youth in the congregation, so I want to remind our families that we have camperships here at the church to cover up to half of the registration fee for those going to camp, and also want to highlight our family camp, which you'll be hearing more about. But with all of this, let's gather around our campfire for some campfire singing.
Hello? Yeah. This is what we do almost every evening at camp. We all gather around the campfire. People bring marshmallows, hot dogs, cooking whatever they want to eat that night. We sing, we laugh, we tell stories. We have a great time. And the kids, I'm so thankful to have all these kids here today because they're so much a part of our camp. I'm looking out to all you people, and we'd love to have you all there. It's so much fun. If you have any ideas about camping, talk to Karen and Frank. They can connect you with tents or spots where you can stay. Hunter, come on up. Hunter, come on up. Oh my gosh, I didn't know he was here. He's such a part of our camp. You probably saw him being baptized in the pictures a few years ago by Pastor Joe. So, okay. Anyway, so we usually ask if people want to request songs. And so anybody here want to request a song? Yes. Yeah, we love that. I decided to follow Jesus. Let's do that. Pardon? Roy said wise choice to follow Jesus. I think he's right.
Decided to follow Jesus. I have Thank you.
love Swing Low, right? Okay. Let's do Swing Low.
She said, of course you say that after I sit down. So I said, stand or sit or whatever you like. Here we go.
Thank you.
As we move towards our time of offering, I'm mindful of camp. And whether it's at the Lake Michigan campground or Wesley Woods or Lake Huron Camp and Retreat Center or Lake Louise or Bayshore or Warner Camp or Camp Barrackell, there's all sorts of things that happen throughout the summer at camp. You can have campfires, of course, time at the beach for sure, walking around a lake for sure, evening vespers, weekly revivals, and it's a reminder to me, there's disc golf, and there's go-kart racing, and there's finding your favorite ice cream spot. There's being spun out on the go-kart track by Stephen Sisson. I'm just saying that to warn those who are coming to family camp this summer. But all sorts of things come together to glorify God as the as a gathered community comes together. As special as camp is, that's a reflection of our lives. We have participate and do. Planting gardens, keeping the house orderly, these random conversations we might share with friends or family, coming alongside people who are hurting, coming alongside people who are celebrating. And just like at camp, we gather it up and we offer it up to God as a testimony of who God is. What God is doing in our lives and in our world. And so this morning, as we give of our tithes and offerings, let us be mindful of all that we have to give to God. Kay, would you come forward for our prayer, please?
Let's pray. Loving Creator, we come together to present our tithes and offering. We are reminded of the profound love which you have called us your children. Help us recognize that our generosity and stewardship of the resources you've entrusted to us are a sign of our commitment to this holy transformation. May these offerings we bring today be a reflection of our love for you and our desire to be faithful stewards of your blessings. Bless our giving and guide us in using these gifts wisely. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm going to sing, "Here I Am, Lord," for the offering. And my hope is that all of you will listen to the words. Sometimes we sing songs and we just say the words. But this song is so impactful. I just hope you'll all listen to the words and sing along with your heart.
Are you sure?
I am the Savior.
Oh, okay. I don't knock it over.
Okay. I get to do the boring part. Huh? Okay. I get to do the boring part, and I would rather just be behind the scene enjoying the moments. Like, I don't know if anybody noticed, Pokemon is helping roast marshmallows today. And there's conversations going on amongst the kids. And as I look out at the congregation, none of you are sitting still. You're moving. Beth and I somehow ended up doing the candy and nut sales about, what were we talking, 7 or 8 years ago? And we were trying to figure out how long the camping ministry at Otsego has been going on, and she remembers it as a child, so not to date us, we're going back decades. I'm not going to date it any more than that. I'm old enough to know I'm not going to date it any more than that. But through the decades, this congregation has sent hundreds, if you begin to do the math, hundreds of children and youth to camp to experience God. And for, is it 43 years now? Because it's the 43rd Games? 43 years that this church has been organizing a family camp. And so the church really recognizes something that Beth and I, we kind of put together a statement that guides our work. And it's, we as a church believe that getting children of all ages, and you're all children of God, so that means all of you, outside to experience the wonder and awe of God's creation is one of the most effective tools we can use to grow our relationship with Christ. It comes because we pause. Pausing is hard to do in our world today. There's a lot going on. For us as a nation, as a community, as individuals, as a congregation, some days it's hard to pause. And remember that God is sovereign. But when you get outside, whether you get the sunshine or the torrential downpours, whether you get the beachfront or the giant trees, whether you get the butterfly flying past you as you weed the garden, he reminds you that he is sovereign and life is precious. And the sun will come up again tomorrow with him in it. That's the power of camp. And this congregation continues to support it in many ways, through your presence, through your contributions. Beth and I are grateful that you buy hundreds of packages of nuts. There'll be some there in the fellowship hall today. By making outright donations and memorial contributions. Last year, we sent 11 children and youth to camp, and they went to a variety of camps. They went to some conference-affiliated camps like Wesley Woods. They also went to some local camps like Beach Point. Junie, you went to horse camp, right? At Beach Point. Piper headed to Lake Louise, which this congregation, I'm saying Lake Louise for the moment. Piper does two camps. She does one through a scholarship that you help fund, and then we also do Sun Life. We do Lake Louise and Sun Life. There are all kinds of options. Day camps at Sun Life and Beach Point. Resident camps at Warner Camp, Beach Point, Sun Life, Wesley Woods, Lake Louise. We will pay up to half of the fee for anybody that's affiliated with our congregation. So all of these young people up here have the opportunity to have this funded. but so do the people in the community that you might know that need that touch. If they know you, if they're a grandchild, help us get them to camp, because that's where they can really pause and experience God's love. And they do it in their own terms. Sometimes as a mom, I push my viewpoint. This allows them to develop their faith and grow in a different way with the help of other adults, because they're going to need that in their faith journey. The scholarship funds not only help get the kids to camp, but we've also started supporting the family camp the last couple of years, helping them with some of their expenses as well. So you're not just supporting the kids. I don't know. Thank you. I'm going to shut up because I told Pastor Jeremy we are not burning a runover card this year. So with that, who's up next? I think it's you guys.
Good morning. I'm going to talk for just a minute about family camp. Yes, just a minute. While Karen and I hold the title of camp dean, not all of it sits on our shoulders. All of these people who I love camping with every summer take a piece. We have devotion leaders, we have song leaders, we have craft leaders. We do this together, okay? And it's a week that Karen and I look forward to every July, and it's coming up soon. This summer will be the 43rd annual Pentwater Games. Okay. One of our recent additions, like 3 years ago, Lorna and Craig's like, we need another meal together. Let's make soup. And they said to Donna, let's have everybody help make soup. And Donna's like, okay. And she brought her pot, and everybody was assigned an ingredient. And Wednesday, Donna stands over the fire and she's pouring stuff in and she's stirring stuff up. And by 6:30 Wednesday night, there is an amazing pot of soup for all of us to share. We've changed a little bit each year, done a different recipe, but it's always a great meal. Now, this summer, to keep with the games idea, we are gonna switch up the soup and we're having a chili cook-off, and I'm really hoping it's not 95 degrees and humid. We'll see what happens. But if you wanna come camp and you've got a chili recipe that great grandma gave you and you're not allowed to share the recipe for, very soon we'll have a sign up for our chili cook-off. So Karen and I would love to talk to you about family camp. Almost everybody up here is qualified to talk to you about family camp. So come out to Pentwater with us, camp across the dune from Lake Michigan, play some cards, eat some chili, sing some songs, and have a great time out in God's creation.
Hey, Frank.
Hey, Karen.
What constitutes a family?
Well, there are these four ladies in the tent who make more noise than the rest of the camp together.
Whoa.
So, yeah. So, come to camp. All right. Children's moment.
One of the best times of all camp is the kids.
Yay! Yay!
Around the campfire.
Okay. Just don't let me get burned, because I'm really afraid of... No, I'm not. I'm just teasing. I'm going to go back here. Now, Frank said that camp doesn't happen just because of one body. Don't put the balloon in the fire, Mr. Jim. That's right. Camp doesn't happen just because of one body. It's a body. Work with me, Piper. It takes many feet to walk through the area to make sure it's safe, to make sure we're having fun, to make sure that everyone is safe. Not only does it take feet, but it takes many hands to make everything work the way it needs to work. Frank and I can't do it. We can't do it by ourselves. It takes many hands to make things work. We need eyeballs all over the place for God sightings, for people to see the wonderful sunsets Some of you weirdos even see the sun rises. That's usually Carl and Louise. There are you see sunrises? There are many happy things that happen at camp. We need the word spread about how awesome camp is. How many of you guys remember that pancake breakfast we had that the camp supplied and that camp that, like, I mean, I'm not kidding. It was for one of your grandkids, wasn't it, Zaina? Yeah, he's still eating it, isn't he? Yeah. We need to smell. Take time. Smell nature. God knows the good things that are happening. We need to take the time to stop and reflect and listen to what God has planned for each and every one of us, each and every day. Also, there are many hats everyone wears every day. What hat will you be wearing to help at camp, to play, to sing, to dance, to experience the amazing love of God, no matter where we are? It takes all parts of God's body, of which you all are, to help make every day amazing.
I want all of you to stand up.
Okay, you guys need to put your marshmallows into the fire. Don't worry, I'll give them. It's okay.
All right, and all you kids, stand up. And guess what we're going to sing? For those of you who know, we usually do this one with the kids. I am a C. Now the words, the letters are all going to be up on the screen, and we want you all to follow along with us, okay? We're going to start really slow, and then we get really fast. So here we go.
Love.
feet. What you just saw there is really what goes on at camp. Good morning, everybody. If I may, I'd like to set the stage a little bit for our morning devotions that we do at camp. Generally, around 9:30. It's just voluntary. Folks come around the campfire, and normally we have to waft the smoke out of our faces. Is that all part of the whole? Yeah, if you come in late, you will be sitting in the downwind section of the fire. So those, all the tears aren't necessarily emotional tears. Those are, smoke gets in your eyes. Everybody brings their coffee, their tea, their lawn chairs. We sit before the rugged cross. The cross right here looks very much like the one around the campfire at Pentwater Campground. At this point, the little people have all gone off to the pavilion, just like Carrie has done with our little people here. And they're doing crafts over in the pavilion. You can often hear the hammers pounding away around the campfire, and that's really kind of music to our ears to hear those little people. A lot of laughter going on over there. The campfire is burning brightly. Chief Morwood, Darl, has seen to that. There's always a big stack of firewood near the fire. And that's largely a bunch of us guys go over and split wood. We generally try not to run the chainsaws, though that's not unheard of. And we split the firewood, and Frank hauls it in his truck, brings it over, and we pile it up near the fire so it just doesn't happen by accident. And then usually by the time we gather, Darl has gotten up early and gone out and built up the fire so that it can be seen from the International Space Station. So. We don't call him Chief Morwood for nothing. We normally start our devotions with a word of prayer. So if you would please join me in prayer. Lord God, we thank you that we can gather together in your house or around the beautiful outdoor arena that is Pentwater on one of nature's most beautiful inland lakes. We pray that your Holy Spirit will fill us, will guide our conversation, our words, our thoughts,
our emotions as we look into your word this morning. And please fill us with your spirit and work in and through our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This morning's devotion, everything has to do, all of our devotions generally have to do with something outdoors, nature. This morning's is typical of that. If you've ever tried to start a campfire and keep it going all night, you know it has to be done just right. Our campfires often are rained on, so Darl starts from scratch in the morning, but with his blowtorch, he gets the job done. You'll need the proper materials and some skill. A great campfire starts with some wood shavings at the bottom, then add some kindling and dry wood piled up just right. You have to allow for proper airflow to get the flame going good, and of course, your power source, something to light that baby up. Discovering our God-given gifts and abilities takes the same careful attention as starting and maintaining a campfire. Our gifts from God are ignited when we believe and use them for His purposes, because God wants us to fan our gifts into flame. He gives us exactly what we need to identify and develop them, a spirit of boldness, power, love, and discipline. As the Word says, in 1 Timothy 1, verses 6 and 7, one that I often need to think of in trying times to recognize the power that is within me and within all of us. 1 Timothy 1, verse 6, "For this reason I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline." When we love the way Jesus loves, our passion reveals our gifts. Once identified, self-discipline with maintenance and regular use will develop our gift into the perfect instrument of God's will. When we let God work through us for His purposes, He gives us the power to use our gifts in supernatural ways. The fire God ignites when we know and use our gifts cannot be contained like a campfire. God also gives us the boldness to use our gifts to serve everyone we meet, to fan our flame into a roaring bonfire whose light would pierce the darkness for miles. In the Gospel of Matthew, he quotes Jesus speaking in the Sermon on the Mount. And Jesus told his followers then, and he's telling us today, "You are the light of the world. A city and a hill on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good work, your good deeds, and praise your Father in heaven." At this time, normally around the campfire, we offer a time of sharing and with some questions that hopefully provoke some thought, some insight, some deep reflection. For example, do you need help identifying your spiritual gift? We all have spiritual gifts. What are you passionate about? What are you good at? And normally we would talk about this issue for 5 or 10 minutes. And is your next step to start serving in the church? What's holding you back? And what would you do for God if you knew you could not fail? How can you take a step this week toward pursuing that dream? And these last three questions, of course, we spend some time on. And so we normally our time around the campfire might go half an hour, maybe even 45 minutes or so. But we all get a chance to, for those who feel so inclined, so led, to speak what's on our heart and maybe spark an interest in someone else as well. So this is what campfire devotions are about. And they enrich our days around Bentwater Camp. And hopefully we all leave there a little richer and more fired up and ready to go out and do God's will. And then we close with a word of prayer, so let us do that as well. Our dear Lord, we thank you for your presence in our lives. We pray that as we think about your word and come to grips with your word, that we feel inspired, led by your Holy Spirit, to get out and change the world and make the world a better place. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Craig. I'm going to share a time of prayer this morning. Direct your attention to those we continue to pray for as a campground and as a church. They're on the cover of our bulletin this morning. You'll find that we've added a number of individuals and asked that we would be mindful of them along with all others who are on our list. We lift up Jerry's son and Louise and Karen's brother and Marilyn's stepson, John. I want to be praying for Kay. And also lift up for us this morning, new to our prayer list, is Joyce's friend, Lorraine. And so we pray for Lorraine. Also want to share some concerns that have been shared with me, so they're not in your bulletin as of this morning. I want to lift up Anthony Kowoff, who is a member of the Plainwell High School National Honor Society. Him and his peers are heading out this afternoon onto US 131 to clean up the roadway from starting at 1 o'clock today. And so Anthony's blessed with a mama who loves him and dad. And so we're going to join Sean in praying for their sons and his peers' safety this afternoon. I also want to lift up this morning a concern that has been shared with me, Tim Brewster, who many of us are accustomed to having as our gatekeeper here at the church, so to speak. You know, it's a term from the Psalms. But he's the one who opens the church and gets the Spirit moving in our church. Tim received a diagnosis this week of multiple myeloma. And so Tim is asking that we lift him in prayers, and I trust that we will be doing so. So let us be praying for Tim. And also, of course, want to add our upcoming general conference that starts this Tuesday and will run through May 3rd. It's the worldwide gathering of United Methodist clergy and laity and bishops to do the work of the denomination. As we know, it's a consequential work. And so want to be lifting in prayer all the travel that is involved for the delegates. Want to lift up the decisions that are going to be made and how they will be impacting churches in each of our communities. Certainly want to be lifting our Bishop David Bard and the delegates who go to represent us and all the United Methodist churches in Michigan. And most of all, want to be praying for our congregation's discernment of what path sets us on the firmest ground to continue this very work that we're experiencing this morning. Of being a place where Jesus' love is lived. And so let's lean into those prayers that we've been lifting up for the past 40 days, 5,760-some prayers that wrap our hearts around God's heart. That we might be mindful of the future we have, one with hope, and one that is good. And so let us take all this to God in our prayers.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we gather around your campfire. Your fire that has been burning even before the start of time. Lord, your fire that draws those who are in the dark to your light. Your fire that gathers the sacred community, allows us to experience, allows us to grow, allows us to go out as a spark in this world, to bring your presence, to bring your holiness, to bring your mercy, and to bring your love. We pray that you would continue to stoke that fire within us that Craig spoke of using our gifts to do your work and for your glory always. So help us to identify those gifts and how we might use them, whether we are the feet or the hands or the eyes or the nose or the ears of your very body. Lord, you know, as we gather together, we are mindful of those we are praying for. We add to our prayers this week prayers for John, prayers for Kay and for Lorraine. Lord, with each one, come alongside them. Come alongside their families, their friends, and us who love them. May we know all of your faithfulness today, even in times of trial. We pray for Anthony, and we pray for his peers, and we thank you for their good that they will be doing in our community. And at the same time, we pray for them this afternoon, even now, for drivers who will be passing them on the roadway, for those who will be doing the work. Just bring an attentiveness, O Lord, that all would be safe. We pray for our brother Tim. Pray for his health. Pray that we might continue to walk alongside him as we have for so many of his decades. And together, may we rejoice in your goodness, in your presence in his life. And Lord, you know our prayers for our congregation, for our church, for our vision of being a place where Jesus' love is lived. You know our prayers for the church as it gathers for General Conference. With so much uncertainty, with the weight of decisions, and even in some corners of your very church, Lord, you know of the contentiousness that exists within your body. And yet we know that your grace is sufficient. We know that your grace and guidance will set our church, the Otsego Church, the Church of Jesus Christ worldwide, that you will continue to set this church on firm ground. And so we pray for all the travel that will be taking place. We pray for all the delegates who are representing others with them. We pray for our Bishop David Bard. We pray for our delegates from here in Michigan. And we pray that you would guide the work of the church gathered in Charlotte. And Lord, even if we can't map what it looks like today, we just know that you will blow through your church as you blow through the many campgrounds of Michigan, and know that your Holy Spirit will sustain us. And so we give you thanks. We give you praise as we pray this all in Jesus' name, praying the prayer that Jesus has taught us to pray, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Obviously, at camp, we have no deadlines, so we sometimes sing for 2-3 hours. So we had a hard time planning for this, to shorten it up. But anyway, we had two songs for the end, but we're going to eliminate one in the interest of time. And we're going to sing one that we love to close the campfire with. But first, I want to thank Joyce, who always brings an amazing antique organ around the campfire and plays for us. I want to thank all of our musicians back there who are amazing, and they add so much fun to camp. And I want to thank all of these people who were willing to participate with us, come up here and do what we do at camp. So thank you all for being with us, and hopefully you'll consider coming to camp with us. It can be one night, it can be a week, whatever, but see Karen and Frank, they'll set you up. So all right, let's do Sanctuary.
Lord, prepare me in a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living. Sanctuary.
Like all good campfires, we have plenty of snacks, even hot dogs in the fellowship hall. Wanted to invite you to that time together. But until our camps this summer, over at Warner Camp, Barrickell Camp, Lake Louise, Bay Shore, Wesley Woods, Lake Michigan Campground in Pentwater, Bay Shore Camp in Sebewing, Lake Huron Camp. Until then, let us go and be that living sanctuary. Amen.
Amen. For us blind, but now I see.